The launch and commissioning of the James Webb Space Telescope, the most powerful and costly telescope ever, has generated enthusiasm in the scientific world. Expectations are understandably quite high. Can the JWST, nevertheless, live up to these expectations? With the terrifying discovery the Space Observatory made on Jupiter, scientists were able to provide an early response to that question. What has been discovered on Jupiter by the most powerful telescope ever built? Have aliens been discovered on this enormous planet? Should we be worried? Welcome to our channel, guys. In today's video, we'll discuss the James Webb Telescope's unexpected image of Jupiter that shocked the entire industry. Before that, do subscribe to our channel if you haven't already. With the deepest and clearest infrared photos of the furthest reaches of the universe to date, the first wave of images provided us with a stunning perspective on the cosmos. The deep field picture depicts a wide variety of galaxies, as they would have looked between 4.6 and 13 billion years ago. The newly discovered photographs demonstrate that the enormous telescope in the deep space is able to see cosmic things that are not merely very far away. This time, it is also capable of viewing individuals who are closest to us. Following up on the telescope's initial magnificent views of the furthest reaches of the cosmos becomes something a bit closer to home. It can take pictures of celestial objects in our neighborhood, as well as galaxies in the cosmos. We have never had better views of the universe than those provided by NASA's James Webb Satellite Telescope. To put it gently, the fresh photographs transmitted by the space telescope show the extraordinary images taken by the JWST camera. Jupiter, our solar system's biggest planet, and its moons can now be viewed in extraordinarily fine detail. NASA has made images available from the space mission's instrument's first test. The pictures show how the JWST can capture even the smallest features in space, such very brilliant objects that are close to the planet. The photographs were collected to test the telescope's equipment and contain spectra of various asteroids as well as pictures of Jupiter. These images will be well known to Jupiter lovers. The infrared camera on Webb acquired the image of the biggest planet in our solar system. The NIRCam instrument's short wavelength filter may be used to observe the huge red spot, an Earth-sized storm and unique bands that surround the planet. Because of the way Webb's infrared image was processed, the discernible point in this picture looks white. The photographs of Jupiter show the whole spectrum of what Webb is able to view. According to Brian Haller, a scientist at the Space Telescope Science Institute in Baltimore, who assisted in the planning of these observations, from planets in our own cosmic backyard that you can see with the naked eye, from your real backyard to the darkest, most distant detectable galaxies, when paired with the previously released deep field photos, they show the complete breadth of what Webb is able to see. On December 25th, 2021, the Webb spacecraft was scheduled to launch with the aim of determining how the universe's initial stars and galaxies arose. On the other hand, the infrared observatory is a highly flexible instrument that astronomers will use to study a variety of cosmic objects and processes, including those in our own solar system. The photos of Jupiter demonstrate the Webb telescope's ability to detect fine features of Jupiter and its massive moons because of its mirror, which is 21 feet wide. Because of the ability of the equipment to collect light at infrared wavelengths, which are redder than visible light, a distinct viewpoint has been provided by the Hubble Space Telescope, which has been operational for more than 30 years. Europa, the target of NASA's planned Europa Clipper mission, a moon with a suspected ocean under its thick ice surface, is plainly seen at the left. Two other moons, Metis and Europa Shadow, may also be seen in the photos to the left of the huge red spot. The Deputy Project Scientists for Planetary Science for Stephanie Malam Webb at NASA's Goddard Space Flight Center in Greenbelt, Maryland, said she couldn't believe how brilliant and clear everything seemed to be. It is tremendously thrilling for them to have the chance to see these kinds of things in our solar system. The fact that these new photographs demonstrated that Webb technology can see satellites and rings near brilliant solar system objects piqued the curiosity of scientists more than usual. In order to investigate the intriguing claim that we may see material plumes erupting from moons like Europa and Saturn's moon Enceladus, scientists will use the Webb Space Telescope. Webb could be used to distinguish the specific traces that material dumping plumes have left on Europa's surface. Even weirder, according to Malam, James Webb was able to traverse across the field of vision of this telescope and conduct what amounts to 3 independent views of the solar system. This indicates that the telescope is strong enough to search for stars even when it's near to a bright astronomical planet like Jupiter. A handful of Jupiter's rings, which are especially apparent in the long wavelength filter picture, were also successfully captured by Webb. Malam thinks that it is fantastic and astonishing that the ring appears in one of Webb's early photographs of the solar system. The narrowband filters allow us to see Jupiter's complete disk in stunning detail. Actually, the purpose of the telescope is to see the very earliest stars and galaxies in the cosmos. They will be looking back at the universe's infancy, she continued. They can already have a sense of how strong this observatory is from these first photographs. This picture has a number of galaxies, and anything you can make out is a far-off object. The plethora of extra information on the exceedingly faint objects in these photographs, however, came as a very nice surprise. Webb also took these images of Jupiter and Europa across the telescope's field of vision with around 1 minute of exposure time. This test showed the observatory's capability to locate and follow guiding stars close to Jupiter's brilliant eye throughout the course of 3 observations. The speed at which a moving item may be monitored online. During commissioning, this test was a crucial query for asteroids and comet researchers. Using the asteroid 6481 Tenzing, which is situated in the asteroid belt between Mars and Jupiter, Webb began the moving target tracking speed limit experiments. With a maximum speed of 30 billion miles per second, it has set the bar for Webb's object tracking. The Webb crew saw numerous asteroids while it was in commission. Moreover, they all appeared as dots since they were all so little. The researchers demonstrated that even for objects moving up to 67 billionths of a second every second, which is more than double the baseline, the Webb would still get valuable data. Beautiful footage shows Jupiter to be a spinning globe. Watching the brand new movie as Jupiter holds on tightly is similar to taking a snapshot of a turtle crawling while you're standing a mile away from it, from the Juno spacecraft. The viewpoint of NASA's Juno spacecraft on April 9, 2022, when it flew just 250 miles above the gas giant clouds, is seen in this accelerated picture. During this Juno's 41st pass above the radiation-emitting planet, the spacecraft's peak speed in respect to Jupiter was 131 miles per hour. It circles the planet at a speed that is nearly 5 times faster than the International Space Station, which orbits at a speed that is more than 7 times faster. Picture of the Apollo mission's Voyager as they set off for the moon. The colorful photos were produced using the JuneCam's instrument's raw photographs and published by authorities to an image processing gallery so that citizen scientists may add their views to the raw data. NASA allowed an extension of the mission's mandate in January 2021 to focus a bit more intensely on Jupiter's 4 big moons. Despite the fact that Jupiter was originally the mission's principal objective, in particular, Ganymede, Europa, will continue to function until September 25th if everything goes well. The combined efforts of around 20,000 engineers, astronomers, and technicians over a 30-year period led to the creation of the Webb Telescope. The multi-billion dollar project, a partnership between NASA, the European Space Agency, and the Canadian Space Agency, aims to shed light on some of humanity's greatest mysteries, including the composition and origins of the universe and our place within it. The James Webb is set to be a fruitful source of breathtaking space imagery and data in the years to come. So what do you think about these scientific advancements? Let us know in the comment section below. And while you do that, do not forget to give us a like and do subscribe to our channel for more updates. Thanks for watching.